Hello and welcome to Iman Driving School. I hope all of you are safe and well. Taking a practical driving test is nerve-wracking and stressful, so I want to make that process as easy as possible for you guys. In this video, I'm going to talk about some real major and serious driving faults that people have made in recent tests and how you can avoid them in your driving test. The first real test major fault involves a mini roundabout. As you can see, a mini roundabout is coming up ahead. In this test, the student didn't anticipate it and clearly missed it. He should have followed a standard routine which involves looking ahead for the roundabout by keeping an eye out for signs and road markings, checking the center mirror, signaling if it's necessary, slowing the car down, and on approaching that roundabout, looking on your right for any possible dangers. This could be cyclist, motorcyclist, or any other vehicle. You need to make sure you follow this routine, as in the test, this will be a major or serious fault. The second real test major fault involves approaching a traffic light junction. As you can see, a traffic light junction is coming up ahead and the examiner asked the student to turn right. The student crossed the green light and attempted to turn right without stopping and anticipating oncoming traffic. Hence, the examiner physically intervened and stopped the car by using dual control, as the oncoming traffic had the priority on this approaching junction. You need to make sure that on traffic control light junctions, you stop and wait in the middle of the junction and give priority to oncoming traffic, unless there is a filter arrow green light. Otherwise, you have to wait in the middle of the junction for oncoming traffic once the safe gap comes or the light changes from green to amber and then red. You should then proceed as you are allowed to go within a few seconds after the light has changed. The third real test major fault involves meeting other traffic, anticipation, and awareness. As you can see, there is a meeting situation coming up ahead in which there is a big truck approaching from the other side. The student tried to give way to the truck by pulling the car on the left, which is fine, but kept going closer and closer to the parked car in front without leaving adequate space to steer out, which caused the major fault. The examiner physically intervened and stopped the car by using dual control and then helped the student to reverse the car first and steer out afterwards. You may notice that initially the truck driver tried to give way by flashing the lights, which the student clearly missed. The lesson to take home from this incident is that firstly, you shouldn't go that much closer to a parked car while you are giving way to someone, because you may not be able to steer out easily and may brush the parked car. Secondly, you should be aware and adapt to situations quickly by anticipating that if the oncoming vehicle driver is giving you way by flashing the lights, their body language, or their vehicle positioning, then you should carry on driving like the other cars in this video clip. I hope you guys understand this major fault situation and hopefully you can avoid it in your own practical test. The fourth real test major fault involves the positioning at an emerging junction. As you can see, there is a T-junction coming up ahead. In this test, the student for some reason got confused and attempted to turn right from the right-hand side, which is a major fault for incorrect positioning at an emerging junction. He was impeding the lane and was turning right incorrectly. Hence, the examiner physically intervened and used his hand to pull the steer back to the left-hand side and corrected his positioning. You need to make sure that you keep your car positioned correctly and watch out for the road markings and signs to avoid making unwanted mistakes and putting other road users in danger. The fifth real major fault involves an emerging junction from the slip road without an effective observation. In this situation, the student did not anticipate and missed the emerging junction. He attempted to proceed without following the standard routine, which involves anticipation, awareness to slow the car down, and observation on your hard shoulder for any possible danger. Hence, the examiner physically intervened and slammed the brake by using dual control. You need to make sure to always anticipate, look ahead, slow the car down, and do effective observation on your hard shoulder when it's safe to do so, as you are emerging at a junction from a slip road. I hope you found this real major test faults video useful. Please try to understand all these mistakes as best as you can so you don't make them in your own practical driving test. Well guys, thanks for watching the video. I wish you all the best for your future driving test. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. Be safe, take care, and I will see you soon in the next video.